Hey guys, catch you at a bad time. Christine Hill with Sunshine Prosthetics, or as most of my patients like to call me, the leg lady. I am a American board certified prosthetist orthotist. I make prosthetic legs and I care for amputees. And welcome to my office. I'm going to be taking you guys on a tour of Little Tank, and if you are curious how Little Tank got his name, go ahead and comment down below and I would love to share that story with you. So we will get started in the cab. First of all, hand sanitizer, which I've always had even before this COVID crap. Never had to carry a mask around, but still need to have that when going into facilities. Name pad, you know, now more important, especially with half my face covered. And we also got my little hip and pelvis model hanging up here. And box of gloves so I can just grab them and go. Now we will jump in the back and go to the fun stuff that makes my job of doing prosthetics and caring for amputees on the road possible. We're gonna start with a quick overview. Stay tuned to the end and I'll show you my newest upgrade that I'm really excited about. So just quick and dirty overview. I have this left bin that has all my casting supplies. I have this right bin that just has sheets of foam material along with sockets that are ready to be fit and things that are ready to be delivered. A couple hand tools, a couple cases of parts and pieces, socks shrinkers for prosthetic, box I use for trash. A couple little things here when it comes to pad shapes and skin stuff, and we'll get a little bit into that. And then I have this bad boy, which is new, and I will be talking a little bit about near the end. So starting with this first bin, this is all my casting supplies. So when I'm going in to evaluate a patient or I know I'm going to be casting, this is where I start and get everything that I need in one place. This is my casting bag that I'll bring in that I put all the supplies into. Casting tape that we actually use to take the impression. This is cut strip if we're doing more like an ankle foot orthosis. For prosthetists out there, these are awesome. They're relatively inexpensive and they're awesome for transfemoral casts. They're basically like pre-made stockinette short. Like I said, they're relatively inexpensive, so those are awesome. Highly recommend. I'll do a separate video on our transfem casting technique, but just to give you kind of a teaser, we got a set of ratchet straps. So basically like a tourniquets that you would find in an EMT vehicle. And we use those to hold these three pieces into place on the patient's limb. Just let me move this to side. So I have my set of liners. I have a set of 6mm liners and 3mm liners. And then, so moving to the box, a set of bologna shrinkers or transtibial shrinkers, and then above knee or transfemoral shrinkers. And then we have the set of socks that we provide at delivery in two different thicknesses, and we got the pack of single plies as well. So when I'm ready to do a delivery, I can just jump to this box, grab what I need, or if I need one for a fitting, they're all right here and ready to go. So parts and pieces. So I have three main cases, and the ones on top are the stuff that I use most often. And we'll just take a little quick peek here. Super glue, Loctite for days, lanyard strap. These are all the 4mm screws. Got a couple set screws because they tend to unthread themselves out of these just with the vibrations of the vehicle. We also got tape measures, locking pins, spare because I have locked myself out of the truck, manual locks, and had to wait for hubby to come and get me the spare key. So I just keep a spare key in the back just in case so I do not get locked out again. Okie dokie, next up we got, what's in here? This is a lot of like the connection type componentry. So these are basically the components that help connect the socket to the rest of the leg. Got a couple different size tube clamps. delivery stickers, rolls of tape. We got bumpers for feet and knees, knee replacement parts, grace plates. So again, these are all just things that you'll have this piece inside the socket, this piece outside the socket, help connect the socket to the rest of the prosthesis. And last bin that we're looking at, this is stuff that I use not as often. Some shafts, speedy rivet, adjust-a-lifts. These are awesome and pretty versatile to add different lengths to the heel. And therapists love these, so I like to have a couple on hand. Zip ties. For the prosthetist out there, if you're ever using manual locking knees, we're usually using the Medi OFM2 manual locking knee, but if you're using any knee that has a manual lock lever type thing, you are probably aware of how frustrating and finicky that can be, especially with something like the Medi OFM2. It basically has a little spring that attaches, it connects the manual locking portion, basically a little lever that the patient pulls to unlock the knee, and it's connecting it to the line that actually goes to the knee that locks and unlocks the knee. That tends to wear out. It can be a point of aggravation. So a lot of times in the field, trying to replace those, handy dandy zip tie works awesome. And for hand tools, I do have a Dremel that I rarely use, especially since I got this bad boy, and also got a just Makita multi-tool. All right, so jumping to the tool bag, I have, what do I got in here? So this is basically a, what's the word I'm looking for? Basically like a fancy shoehorn, because it also has an end that helps take the foot shell on and off prosthetic feet. Skin stuff, I have baby powder. Also alcohol. The main thing that I use this for, especially after grinding on a socket, that carbon fiber dust you do not want on your skin, and you definitely do not want it on your patient's skin. So you are taking a stockinette and wiping that socket down with alcohol to get rid of any carbon fiber dust, because that gets stuck in the liner, that's going to get stuck in their patient's skin, and that is going to be a bad day. I also keep some samples. You can get these from Alps. They're lotion samples. I also keep nipple cream, which might sound weird. I have had a couple patients, especially transtibial patients with amputations below the knee, that sometimes get callusing on that distal tibia, so that distal cut end of the bone there in the front, and this is awesome for that application. Also got a couple of ACE wraps, which if you know a patient is swollen up that day and you're trying to do a check socket fitting, wrap them up in an ACE bandage for 10 minutes and then you can move on with the fitting. I also have, and this might sound like another weird one but maybe not, certain dry antiperspirant samples. I keep this on hand for patients that have just a lot of sweating, especially during the summer, because I have had some patients that have had like skin irritations, and very rarely are patients, you know, allergic or anything like that to the liners. It's usually attributed to things like not washing the liner properly, or if they're starting a new medication or something is getting sweated out in their skin. So if you have a patient that sweats excessively and that's kind of an issue for them, the Certain Dry antiperspirant might be a good option. I also have on here Sharpies, because you never have too many Sharpies. Knife, always have a knife handy. Couple other, you know, miscellaneous hand tools. I do also have a handy dandy skiving knife, which is awesome for pad shaping. And this is kind of all my little collection of kind of pre-made pads and double-sided. So this is carpet tape. All right, so we're saving this bad boy for last. So there's just a couple quick things before we jump into that. Like to have gloves in the back handy as well. This is kind of my pylon library for changing heights. Where's the pipe cutter and reamer. Just smooth that inside or outside and inside. A heat gun, drill set, stomper for check socket fitting, set of height boards here, and then got handy dandy torch. And this is all just like my Velcro sandpaper. Also got putty in here. Usually I'm using this for check socket fittings if I'm trying to get a deeper insight, deeper look into where high pressure areas are. And in this last box here, we got gate belt if I need it, fire extinguisher, eye wash stuff, kind of that stuff that they require to have in your vehicle, that some of that safety stuff. And then just like an information postcard type deal that I hand out to facilities when I'm marketing. And a whole stack of delivery bags here.
All right, you guys ready for the new upgrade I've been so excited about?
So I recently got this power converter installed. All right, so once you get the engine started, you just turn this on. You're just gonna flip this switch. And I do got a couple different sanding cones. So I have one, the one on there is a little bit coarser. This one's a little bit finer. And then I have buffing cone as well. This makes it really quick and easy to do grinding on socket type of adjustments, shaping up pads, and things like that. And you wanna make sure you get this turned off. And that is my office. I hope you enjoyed. If you have any specific questions, drop them down below and I will answer them, or maybe even do a deeper dive video on your question or what you're interested in. So, you know, like, subscribe, comment, all that jazz. Just thank you for being here. Thanks for watching. And thank you for just joining me on this journey of making prosthetics and taking care of folks. I will catch you guys next week. Mwah. Bye.